everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am sharing my family's apple sauerkraut recipe. So if that is something that you would like to see, then just keep watching. So I actually never liked sauerkraut. It just looked weird and it tasted kind of weird, and I just never got into it. And it wasn't until I was trying to incorporate more gut healthy and friendly foods into my diet that I decided to like finally break down and start trying to get sauerkraut into my life, because it is a fermented food and it has a lot of that great bacteria to help you maintain and have a healthy gut microbiome, which I explained all about in my Understanding Gut Health series. So if you want, you can go ahead and take a look at that. I'll leave the links for those down below. So I was never a fan and I never enjoyed it. And I remember I talked to my grandmother about it and she shared with me her secrets to making a really good sauerkraut. And I tried it and it was so good. And now I've been making it this way ever since. And that has been for a few years now. So I am sharing this recipe with all of you today. So I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and let's go. So what's great about this recipe is that it only requires a few ingredients. And the first one, as you can see here, is a small onion. Now the onion I had here in this video was more of a medium to large size onion. So I only used about half of it. So the way I chop my onion is that I just take each end off and take off the outer layer, and then I'll take my knife and try to go in about 3/4 of the way through the onion, and then I'll turn it around and go in about 3/4 of the way again, but horizontally, as you can see here. And then when I take my knife and just go vertically down, I get a really nice rough chop that I'm looking for, and it's just a nice, fun, easy way to chop my onion. I actually love chopping. I don't know if you can tell, but anyways, so then I'll just take my knife, I'll use it to kind of bring it all together, chop it one last time to make sure that it's a nice small size, because I like my onion pretty small in all of my recipes for the most part. So when you are done chopping that up, just go ahead and set it aside, and let's move on to the second ingredient, which is one apple. My favorite to use is a Gala apple, but you can use whatever apple you prefer or like the best. And then I'm just gonna go ahead, after washing it, I just peeled it, and then I took my knife and I cut around the core of the apple. Now, I like to thinly slice my apple for this recipe, so it's kind of like big apple chunks, but you can dice it, or my grandmother's favorite way is to grate it. So you can try it in different ways, see which one you prefer or like the best. It's definitely customizable to whatever you prefer. And I always take a bite of the apple because why not? Then you are going to set that aside as well. And then we are going to move on to the third ingredient, which is of course the main star of the show, the sauerkraut. So I took a little bit of a shortcut here and just bought my sauerkraut from the grocery store, but you can of course make it yourself. What I like to do is, since I buy it from the grocery store, is to drain it and rinse it under water, and it helps it so that it's not quite so sour when you eat it. But if you like it more sour, then don't rinse it quite as much. So there you go. Now we're gonna go over to the frying pan, and I just put a little bit of avocado oil in there, and we're gonna start with the onion. So go ahead and put that in there and just give it a quick toss, and then we're gonna cook it until it's nice and brown like this. At this point, we're gonna add in all of the rest of our ingredients. So I just put in the apples, then we're gonna put in the sauerkraut that has been drained and rinsed under water, and then we are going to put in the applesauce. And I used 2 of these little cups, so I think it was about 8 ounces, but I'll have the full recipe down below on my blog, so you can go ahead and check that out if you wanna print it. And then we are going to take our tongs, or you can use a spatula or a spoon, whatever you want, and we are going to mix that all together. And then we need the apples to cook, so we kind of want them to steam a little bit. So usually what I do is just take the pan, go to the sink, and fill it up with water until the sauerkraut and apples are submerged under the water, as you can see here. Then I'll just take my tongs, just give everything a quick toss, make sure everything is under the water or submerged, and then we're gonna let this cook for about 20 to 25 minutes. That's pretty much all you really need in order for these apples to cook, especially since I sliced mine. But if you grate them, it may take less time. So then I would just maybe check it at like 10 or 15 minutes just to see if everything is good to go. But this is what you want it to look like. It's going to be cooking away.
We want it to simmer during this 20 to 25 minutes that it is cooking. This way that the water can evaporate and it won't be super soupy. Then I just usually take my fork around 20 minutes and I will check the apples and see if they are fork tender. And then I will taste it and see if I like the sweetness level. If it's not sweet enough for me, then I'll go ahead and add some more apple juice. So that's what I did there. And then when you are looking to see when it's done, you kind of just take your tongs and move it around. And if you can see the frying pan when you move it around at the bottom, then you're good to go. So you can transfer it to a dish, allow it to cool, and enjoy.
Alrighty, you guys, so that is everything I have for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and if you decide to recreate the recipe, then let me know what you think down in the comments below. But otherwise, that's all I have, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!